Hello and welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to be making the cat quilt. This block is such a fast block to put together, but look at how cute it is. Here is everything you need to make one block. Make it as big as you want. That is the fun part about quilting. Come along and let me show you how I do it. I start out by cutting 5-inch strips. And then I cut the 9.5-inch strip. This will be for the body of the cat. I probably should have just made one block, but here I am going to make two. It is always faster if you do a little chain piecing. And now I am going to cut the 3x5 strips. Now I will cut the 2.5-inch squares. And of the white, I will need a 5-inch strip, which will end up being a 5-inch square. And then my 2.5-inch by 5-inch rectangle. And now I will need 2.5-inch square. This is the fun part. It comes together so fast. You take a 2.5-inch square and put it on your 9.5-inch rectangle and snowball that corner, and that will be the body of the cat. Now is the fun part of making the ears. You take 2.5 inch blue squares and put them on your 2.5 by 5 inch white rectangle and snowball the corners, and it comes together so easy. Then you want to take your 3 by 5 rectangle blue and put your cat ears on top. And look how cute that is and how quick it came together. And then it is time to add your 5-inch square to the cat ears. I really like to iron it after each sew, just to get it to lay flat, makes it easier to sew on the next piece. And then you just want to sew the head with the body and watch it come together. Thank you. I just love how cute this pattern is. It's always a good idea to lay it out to make sure it's going the direction you want it to go, the colors in the right spot. I love my design wall for just this thing. Now I'm going to go ahead and make a bunch of them. I thought about fast forwarding through this, skipping this part, but I thought I would just bring you along and show you how I chain piece them. As fast as you can make these blocks, this could easily be done in a day or a weekend for sure. What a great gift to give to someone that loves their cats. Depending on how you sew your blocks together, I sew with a 1/4 inch seam. My blocks are coming out at 9.5 inches, so I'm going to try to make every one of them exactly the same. In my attempt to make them even, I try to line that line right there. This is the fun part. You get to decide how you want your blocks to look. I like to put a 2.5 inch border in between each one. I'm using a different fabric for this to make it look like the cat is sitting in the window. this is how I like to line it up, because if that is right like that, then it will be right when I sew it. Adding a border around each cat is actually making the quilt bigger, which is kind of nice. I am so happy with the way this turned out. Just think of how you can make it as big as you want. You can make a queen size. Just keep adding cats. I like to trim the edge just a little if there's any spots that are sticking out. I am having so much fun making these baby quilts that I bought a king size batting. I really like it. That way I get a whole bunch of pieces out of it. I think it's actually a lot cheaper to do it that way. Then I just pinned it and I'm getting ready to quilt it. I didn't show this part, but I did draw with my chalk lines on this to follow, which made it great, made it so easy. And then I like to hand sew the binding on. I'm starting to add stuff to my Etsy store, so if you want, you can check that out, and I'd like to thank you for watching.